Hi everyone, this is Vishal from Taiki Softwares. Today we'll take a look at a quick demo of the deposits for WooCommerce plugin. That is also one of our most recent plugins that we released. We released that in September 2017, and I'll just walk you through as to what the plugin can do. So as the name says, deposits for WooCommerce, it allows WooCommerce businesses to accept deposit payments, you know, partial payments by either a percentage of the product price or a flat amount. This is generally useful for, you know, high priced items where, you know, you want to just accept a part of the payment at the time of placing the order. This is also very useful in bookings, because in bookings normally, you know, you ask for a upfront payment, and then the rest of the payment is taken at the time of the booking. So this plugin, deposits for WooCommerce, it allows you to accept, you know, deposits by a particular percentage. Let's say you can say 10% as deposit while placing the order, and rest of it can be paid later. Or you can say that you accept, you know, $50 as an initial payment if you want to keep it as a fixed amount, and rest of the balance payment can be paid at the, you know, later stage. Apart from this, this plugin also allows you to create payment plans. So payment plans are typically, you know, like let's say you want your customers to pay over a period of 2 months. So in that case, you know, you can say that at the time of placing the order, you will accept a initial payment of, let's say, 20%. Then after a period of 1 month, you will accept another 50%, and then at the end of the second month, you will accept another payment. So this is the our plugin page on the website. We'll just go through the demo in a minute. This is how, you know, the options look like. You can choose to pay a deposit, or you can choose to pay a full amount. At each and every stage, the customer is informed as to if they are paying a deposit, then what is the amount they are paying. And we have created some, you know, products or use cases which we'll just take a look at right now. So let's say you know, out of these six, you know, there are actually a few more as well which I need to add here, but let's take a look at a few of these six. So let's take a look at the first one, product with deposit by percentage or full payment. So this is the product. As the title says, it's either deposit by percentage or you pay a full payment. So the full amount is selected by default. This also can be customized. You can say that, you know, you want the deposit to be selected by default, then that would be, you know, appear as selected. So now here, as you see, we have kept the deposit as 50%. And the product price is $250. Now if I add to cart, and we go to the view cart page, so as you see, the price is $250 and the total payable right now is $125, and a small message also appears over here, $250 payable in total. So this was one of the cases. Let's take a look at another case, which is the payment plans, product with payment plans or full payment. So this is our product which has payment plans. As you see, the pay full amount appears selected by default. Let's say I'll choose pay deposit. Now I have three different payment plans which I have assigned to this particular product. One is a 2-month plan, one is a 3-month plan, one is a 6-month plan. Depending on your requirements, you can either assign multiple payment plans, or you can simply ask the user to follow a single payment plan. You know, let's say you only want 2-month plan to be available for payment. In this case, let's choose the 3-month payment plan. We select that, we click on add to cart, and if we go to the cart page, so as you see here, the payment plan appears over here, 3-month, the total price, and it says $120 is the initial payment and $300 payable over 3 months. So this is, you know, this is how we have structured the payment plan. This is how, you know, the plugin works. There are many other cases also which you can use this plugin with. For example, it is also compatible with Gravity Forms add-ons. You can also use a variable product with the deposits plugin. So these are options added via the Gravity Forms plugin, Gravity Forms add-on actually. Then you have a variable product as well. And most importantly, this plugin is also compatible with the WooCommerce Bookings plugin from WooCommerce, and it is also compatible with our own booking and appointment plugin for WooCommerce. So if we want to, let's check this booking product. I think this should be, yeah, this is our plugin. Okay, so let's say the price of this product is $345 and pay a deposit of $100 per item. Okay, so I can choose a date, 23rd December. I'll say add to cart, and then if you go to the view cart page, let's look for the booking product. It's here. So here is the date, 23rd December. Here is the total price, and here is the initial deposit, which is $100 for this particular bookable product. This product booking is using our booking and appointment plugin for WooCommerce. So these are the different possibilities which you can cover with the deposits plugin. If we have to take a look at the admin side, then I'll just show it to you. I'll click on admin demo. I think I'm already logged in, otherwise you can log in with the username password demo, which is shown on the login page. Now the settings for global settings for the deposits plugin are under WooCommerce settings, products, and in that we have a deposits section. Right, so here there are various configuration settings, so you can say whether deposits are optional, forced or not, default deposit type, percentage, fixed amount, payment plan, default deposit amount, default payment type, what is the text to display on the product page, and here is the plugin license options for people who have purchased the plugin. And at the product level, we'll just take a look at one of the products very quickly. Oh, just to go back, here is that setting, default payment type. Check if you want pay deposit to be default selection. So otherwise, by default, we keep full payment as selected. If you check this, the deposit payment will appear selected by default for the customers to pay. Now going back to the products, we'll take a look at this one, product with deposit by amount or full payment. Now when you are on the add or edit product page, the deposits settings will appear right in the product data meta box, and as you see over here, this is where you will be able to set up the deposit related settings for that product, whether it's optional or not, the type of deposit, fixed amount, percentage of payment plan, the amount, since it's a fixed amount type, what is the message which you want to show, the deposit text, by default it will show pay a deposit of the amount per item, and payment plans. Now you know, you see these payment plans, since this product is a fixed amount, we are not applying payment plans, but you can create the different payment plans from under the products menu and the payment plans link. It's very easy to create payment plans. So here are the existing payment plans which we were seeing on the front end, and from here you create a new payment plan. Right, so I think it's very simple to set up a deposit product, and we are planning to add some more features in the plugin over the due course of time. The plugin is available for a very reasonable price, I would say. You know, it's the single site license is available only for $39. If you want it for 5 sites, it's $79, and if you want it for 20 stores, it's $99. So this is very reasonable compared to some other expensive plugins in the market which do the same thing or maybe less. We are hoping to add features like disabling some payment methods when deposit products are chosen, and a few others as well. So yeah, I think go ahead and explore the product, explore the demo version. It's a full version demo which we have. We also have 30-day money back guarantee on all our products, so don't hesitate if you want to purchase and are worried if it doesn't fit your needs. There is also this FAQ at the bottom of the page, and I think that's it. Thank you.